Oops. Hi, sorry. This is super muddy. I put the cat down on the camera so I don't see. Today I am going to try and do the Wahkeena Multnomah Falls loop hike. Online it did say that there is still ice and snow up there, so if I get up like by Ferry Falls and it looks bad, then I'll turn around. But so far it's a really nice day out. Right now I'm on the trail that connects Multnomah and Wahkeena down by the highway, and when I get to Wahkeena Falls, I hike up back around to the start of this trail and back to my car. just passed Wahkeena Falls behind me, and I am going to walk up this trail. If I remember right, there's 12 switchbacks to the top of this portion of the trail, and then I go through Wahkeena Canyon to get to Fairy Falls, and onward. This is an old sign for Perdition Trail, and it is now closed. I ran into it when I was over on the other side at Multnomah Falls last spring, and there's actually a sign up on the trail that says closed, but here there is not. Just the old trail sign, but over on the other side it does say it's closed. I really am always tempted to go on this trail, even though it's closed, because I went online and did some research, and so there's some pretty cool pictures, but it's been closed and not maintained for a while, so it's probably unsafe, and I won't be going up there today. I'm going to continue up the switchbacks, but yeah, that is a trail I really like to do, is the Perdition Trail that is closed.
I think that my backpack has put back all the weight on me that I've worked really hard to lose. So, walking up this hill, I don't feel like I've lost any weight. I feel very heavy.
I just got to the top of the second switchback. So there's 10 more. And I have to get all the way up there where the sun's shining. This view from up here is beautiful. Switchback 10. Only two to go. Made it to the top of the 12th switchback. Headed to the viewpoint. Okay, I'm gonna head on to Fairy Falls now before I make the loop. I hate that it's hard to see in video, how steep something like this. I came from down there. Way down there. I don't know. Anyway, like I said, heading on to Fairy Falls before I continue.
you how busy they say it is.
Hello. Hi. I'm at now is called Wahkeena Canyon. Walk through this and Fairy Falls is up there. I'm not too far. There'll be a rocky switchback for like some switchbacks before I get to it. Then we'll see how it is moving on from there. I've never been past there. There's a bunch of snow that hasn't melted yet. Under the tree. Okay, I'm going to switch back. I'm going to go back to the Fairy Falls. I'm going to come on the switch back. Depends on how much I need to keep going. Okay, I've been up six of the rocky switchbacks. And that one right there will be seven. And I think that's the one that gets me to Fairy Falls. There's Fairy Falls. So seven switchbacks from Wahkeena Canyon to Fairy Falls. Last time I was up here, for some reason I thought it was three. I don't know how I didn't know, but I did four switchbacks. Anyway. This is Fairy Falls. This is as far as I've ever been up here before. So, I'm going to head up that way in a minute. I'm going to rest here for a second. And then I'm going to find my way to Wahkeena. When I was looking it up, it said that if you do the whole loop, it's 4.8 miles. And it's over 1,500 elevation range, 1,500 feet. Right now, we're at 800 feet. And a little over 800.
I think about 900 feet is the furthest I've ever hiked up anywhere. So we'll see how I do. Hopefully I make the whole loop. And if I do, that's some comfort food, because that would be the highest, not the longest, but the highest I've hiked so far.
I just wanted to get a video with Fairy Falls behind me. I love this fall. It's so pretty. So I passed Wahkeena Falls, and this is Fairy Falls, and I know I'll pass Multnomah Falls very last on my way down, and from what I read, there's a total of 8 falls, so there should be 5 more falls in between here and Multnomah Falls, and waterfalls are my favorite thing to see while I hike.
Just made it to the top of the 6 switchbacks in total, Fairy Falls. There's at least one more. There might be more than one. Until it says I get to some junction. Anyway, I'm gonna head up the 7th switchback. Okay, so I'm at the top of the 7th switchback, and this is where it tells me the junction is. You can either head left to this the point. That doesn't even look like a trail to me. I'm walking up the creek. And that's trail 419. Or you can head right and keep going up Wahkeena Trail 420. It said that once I get here, I'll climb another 200 feet. And then I have to go there. The directions to see if I turn again. This left and left. Here. Keep on climbing. As you can see, it's on the other. This is kind of open.
I think I may very well be the slowest hiker in the world, but it's okay. I stop a lot to catch my breath, but I get to take in a lot more pretty stuff. And the guy I ran into that last time I was at Fairy Falls, he told me if I continued up here, I would run in to hardly any people. He was right. Since I left Fairy Falls, I haven't ran into anybody. Right up ahead, I see people. It's the first people I see in a very long while. Okay, from the junction that I was just at with the signs, the information I saw earlier before I left home said that it's all downhill from here. So I'm pretty sure I'm close to Multnomah Falls. And I should be down there soon. I don't know, I'll try to record more, but my phone battery sucks and it's almost dead.
my boots, the water seems to be pretty warm. I'm going to talk with them.
Okay, this is pretty narrow. A little more lingering snow. Let's see what this sign says. I'm on trail 420. I'm on and I guess I'm getting off now. Hopefully this next one is over going to go down. I think I'll go back that way. Back down the switchback. Let's see. Okay, Dark Mountain. I'm not gonna go up. So, out of there, down here, there's some people. Since I'm coming towards Multnomah Falls, it's gonna probably start to get more crowded.
Well, the snow is slick.
Maybe I'm the slowest hiker in the world because I keep stopping to take pictures and video. Also, it takes a lot of balance to do video and pictures when you're going down Rocky Hill. I much prefer walking up the rocks than down them.
I can't really tell by looking at this video, but this ground is very, very uneven. Very, very often, and you can see the rock. I don't think you can tell exactly like how uneven it is. At least it's a beautiful day out now. Or maybe it's just not too cold because I'm walking. Oh, good God. This is uneven. At least I know when I get to the trail at Multnomah Falls, it goes down back to the parking lot. It's a lot smoother. Came across another water plant. I don't know what that is, but it's very pretty. I know my phone is about ready to dead because that is not exactly. Whoa. Look at that. Okay, time to stop recording the guy so I don't know. Max space was not that friendly to speak.